Now, this is a topic that's going to get you talking. A female politician in the UK has been ridiculed for arguing mums should be allowed to bring their babies to Parliament. Liberal Democrat Minister and new mum, Jo Swinson, copped backlash from all sides. Even a respected female newsreader said the MP is gaga for thinking she can juggle motherhood and full-time parliamentary work. I've already heard that from you, Jess. Should she be able to take her baby into Parliament?
Of course she should.
Really?
I mean, yes, because I think the thing is, as a working mum, you're juggling all sorts of things and sometimes you may not have a choice. You might still be breastfeeding your baby, childcare might have fallen through that particular day. We need to have more flexible workplaces and I think, I know for me, sometimes you feel like, oh, I've got to hide the fact that you're a mother, that there's this separate part of your life and then your work part. But I think
we need to see both
men and women leading the way and kind of saying, you know what, we are part of
the issue
family.
Here that she thinks women should be able to take their babies into the chamber. Yeah, there's a big difference in going to work in the parliament with your child and taking it into the chamber when you're discussing issues of the day. And I don't think you should take your babies into the chamber.
But what if you have to do a vote? If there's some vital vote that you have to be there.
To someone to mind. You're running a business. I went to a board meeting once and there was a woman there breastfeeding her baby at the board meeting. Now, I have to tell you, it was the most irritating.
Oh, really?
The baby cried. Yes, it was. Let's get serious here. We're running a business. We're not running a creche. If you're in a board meeting, you don't take the baby in there.
But if the baby cries,
you have no choice.
Oh, rubbish.
Yeah, but you
if you want to be a working mother, you've got to make arrangements.
No, but
like, what if I was sitting here on the panel just casually breastfeeding my baby
and,
going, you know,
what
do you
think? Well,
I wouldn't mind.
What if it begins to cry?
Hand it to me and I'd hold the baby because I think we make...
And then it vomits on you.
Well, so what? Wipe it off.
And instead of people watching the show, they're watching you with the baby.
Sometimes feel sort of invisible and they can't be involved. Mm. Elizabeth Broderick, the Sex Discrimination Commissioner, has spoken a lot about we need to make kids more visible in the workplace.
I'm in a place for
sort
a baby
of make a
and
point.
It's not at a TV studio
yeah, but
when we're working.
Sometimes you don't have a choice.
Oh,
and
nonsense.
I think we need to be more supportive of women and working women.
I'm with you on this, Jess. I think any individual should be able to make that decision for themselves. I think if you've got a breastfeeding baby that, like one of my kids was a 5-minute turnaround, one of the four, one of the others was an hour and a half. I couldn't have done anything other than manage that one. You know who you are, kid.
There's always one, isn't there?
I like him now. Hated his guts when he was born. But never mind. You know that you could have, there's a baby that I could have done any job with that child and it wouldn't have distracted me 1 minute.
Well, we've got
to leave it to the individual to make the choice.
Well, George, we've got a bit of feedback coming in on this issue. It's obviously got people fired up. I think there are already enough babies in Parliament, says Brittany Jane. Brittany Jane on Twitter, you have won our tweet of the week. I just made that up then.
We better find a prize.
You're going to win a used Studio 10 cup. Actually, no, I better not.
But I think, I mean, really, it is. The issue with having babies in the chamber is that you cannot be in the chamber of a parliament unless you are an elected representative of a district or of a seat. And so the technicality, and it's already happened here, it happened in Victoria when Kirsty Marshall, a Victorian MP, brought the baby in. It wasn't because of any sort of draconian workplace laws that she was kicked out. She was actually kicked out because there was what's known as a stranger in the house. Which basically means the baby was treated as it would have been if it was a streaker or a protester.
Which was ridiculous. Which was a mean way of excluding her. And I think women's voices at that age, you have so much going on in your life. Mm. You are such a big user of health services, educational services, public transport. You need people who get where you are for that period in your life.
And support you.
And it's a short time. Mm. I just think if you've got a kid that you know can say, well, no one wants to be there with a baby screaming, trying to answer questions or do work, they will remove themselves. I think let those mums who are intelligent, educated people make a decision about what they want to do.
It's best for their kids. Look, it's wonderful to be a modern mother. I haven't got a problem with mothers working, but you've got to be sensible about this. If you have a baby, there are places where babies should be and places where they shouldn't be. And you should stop inflicting your children on us.
Wait a minute.
Yeah, good idea.
What do you mean inflicting?
with your children. You tag them everywhere.
Around.
You tag them to restaurants. They never go to bed. Oh. You know, they're up at 10 o'clock. Right. I mean, save me.
I'm really surprised by your view.
Somebody has to have some common sense here.
No, I think that's too harsh.
No, you don't want babies. You wouldn't want a baby on TV here and say, oh, well, it's my right to breastfeed my baby wherever I want and have, you know, however many viewers we've got. What is it, 1.5 million now? watching it and going... You wouldn't want a government's legislative agenda to be disrupted by.
It points to a wider issue, I think, with women with small children feel invisible.
That's actually
and it's a real struggle.
But you want to make sure we see them.
No, but they feel invisible because...
I'm going to get in trouble for this.
And sometimes, yes, you need to be in a supportive environment that means, yes, I might have to bring my small
You could do what Jeannie Little used to do. Years ago when Jeannie was on Mike Walsh's Midday Show, I remember being in the green room and there was a playpen in there and there was Katie, her daughter. She was the little one. She said, darling, keep an eye on the baby, will you, while I'm on the show? And in she went. Everybody in the green one looked after the baby. It was very well done.
But somebody was supportive of that.
It was in the green room, not in the studio.
Because I mean, you've said to me that I should bring my youngest daughter in here sometimes because she's been...
I did not. I don't want you breastfeeding her at the steps.
Well, I wouldn't, because she's age 4, so I wouldn't still be breastfeeding
Nothing
her.
Nothing would surprise me.
Oh.
She's age 4, she could hope.
And you've said to me, because I've been feeling guilty about, you know, her being at home and all that sort of stuff, you said, bring her in, we'll look after, we'll
be supportive. Very different to have a little kid in the audience.
You never take her into work, your hubby? He does?
Yep.
Okay.
Well, on the news set? Yes. I've never seen her sitting on the Channel 9 news desk while your husband reads it.
She hasn't been... Like she's been while up reading the news, but she's been in his office and all of that.
She can do the weather.
She's too old.
She can do the animal stories.
And the weather for tomorrow is grey and grisly. The weather for Wednesday is also grisly. The weather for Thursday is hungry with a touch of grisly.
All right, we've got to move on.